Hello everyone. Today we will start our first chapter of English book. You have two English books in your syllabus. First book is called Golden Rays and the second book is called Resolution. So first we will start with second book, which is Resolution. Before I start this chapter, I must tell you that be careful while I am reading the chapter. You should listen to it carefully. Once you read any chapter carefully, you can give any answer, whether it is coming from textbook's questions or it is coming from in between the chapter. So be attentive while I am reading this chapter. So let's start. Whenever I will come in this chapter, that means we are talking about the narrator who is telling us about this story, who is a thief. So whenever I will come, that means we are talking about a thief. So let's begin. I was still a thief when I met Anil, and though I was only 15, I was an experienced and very successful hand. So narrator is telling us that he was still a thief when he first met Anil. What was his age? He was around 15 years of age, but he was an experienced and successful thief. We will move to the next line. Anil was watching a wrestling match when I approached him. He was about 25, a tall, lean fellow, and he looked easygoing, kind, and simple, enough for my purpose. I was sure I would be able to win the young man's confidence. In these lines, thief is saying that when he first met Anil, Anil was watching a wrestling match. What is the description of Anil? He was about 25 years old, a tall and lean fellow. He was looking very easygoing, a simple person. It was easy to win his confidence. Next line. You look a bit of a wrestler yourself, I said. A little flattery helps in making friends. When thief met for the first time to Anil, he was watching a wrestling match. So how did he start the conversation? He said to Anil that you look a bit of a wrestler yourself. He flattered. He thought by doing so, he can make friends easily. Next line. So do you, he replied, which put me off for a moment because at that time I was rather thin. So what did Anil reply? Anil also said that you also look like a wrestler, which was not true because thief was only 15 years old. So, well, I said modestly, I do wrestle a bit. Thief said to Anil that he do wrestling to win his confidence. What's your name? Anil asked to the thief, what's his name? Hari Singh, I lied. Thief lied to him and he said his name is Hari Singh. I took a new name every month that kept me ahead of the police and my former employers. He always changed his name every month so that he cannot be get caught by the police or former employers. After this introduction, Anil talked about the well-oiled wrestlers who were grunting, lifting, and throwing each other about. I didn't have much to say. Anil walked away. I followed casually. After the introduction, Anil was talking about wrestlers who were fighting with each other. They were grunting, they were lifting, they were throwing each other. Thief didn't know what to do now. By that time, Anil got up and walked away. So Thief also followed him. "Hello again," he said. Anil said hello to me again. I gave him my most appealing smile. "I want to work for you," I said, "but I cannot pay you." So Thief asked Anil, he wants to work for him. But Anil replied, he doesn't have money to pay the thief. I thought that over for a minute, perhaps I had misjudged my man. I asked, "Can you feed me?" Thief thought he might have misjudged this man. He thought he was a wealthy man and it was easy to make fool of him. He asked Anil, "Can he feed him?" Anil replied, "Can you cook?" Hari Singh replied, "I can cook." I lied again. Thief said he can cook, but he lied again, which means he doesn't know how to cook. "If you can cook, then maybe I can feed you." Anil said, "If you can cook, you can stay with me and I can give you food." He took me to his room over the sweet shop and told me I could sleep on the balcony. But the meal I cooked that night must have been terrible because Anil gave it to a stray dog and told me to be off. But I just hung around, smiling in my most appealing way, and he couldn't help laughing. So Thief Hari Singh went with Anil to his room, which was over the sweet shop. When they went to their room, Anil told Hari Singh to sleep on the balcony. But that night when Hari Singh cooked the meal, it was very terrible because it was not cooked properly. So Anil gave it to the street dogs and told Hari Singh go to sleep. But Hari Singh didn't move. He smiled in his most appealing way and Anil couldn't stop laughing. Anil was laughing by seeing his smile. Later, he patted me on the head and said, "Never mind, he would teach me to cook." He also taught me to write my name and said, "He would soon teach me to write whole sentences and to add numbers." I was grateful. I knew that once I could write like an educated man, there would be no limit to what I could achieve. Anil came close to me and patted on my head and he said, "Don't worry, I will teach you how to cook." He also taught me how to write my name and promised me that he will teach me how to write whole sentence and add numbers. I was very happy. The thief was very happy because he knew that once he could write like an educated man, he could become anything. He could become successful. We will move to the next page now. It was quite pleasant working for Anil. I made the tea in the morning and then would take my time buying the day's supplies, usually making a profit of about a rupee a day. I think He knew I made a little money this way, but he did not seem to mind. Few days passed away. Hari Singh was very happy working for Anil. In the morning, he made tea for Anil, and after that, he goes to the market to buy different things for day's supply. After coming from the market, he always tells 1 rupees extra of the amount whichever he spent. By this way, he daily steal 1 rupee from Anil. He thought Anil knew that I am stealing his money daily, but he didn't seem to mind. He didn't say anything. Anil made money by fits and starts. That means he was not a permanent employee. He was not getting a permanent salary. He would borrow 1 week, lend the next. He kept worrying about his next check, but as soon as it arrived, he would go out and celebrate. It seems he wrote for magazines, a queer way to make a living. Sometimes he doesn't have money, so he has to borrow from his friends. And when he has money, he lends the money to his friends. He kept worrying about his next check always. But whenever check arrives, he goes out with his friends and celebrate. It seems like he wrote for magazines and sell his articles or news and get the money. One evening, he came home with a small bundle of notes saying he had just sold a book to a publisher. At night, I saw him tuck the money under the mattress. One evening, when Anil came back from the office, there was a small bundle of notes, rupees, in his hand. He told Anil Singh that he just sold his book to a publisher, so he got the money. At night, Anil tucked the money, means kept the money under the mattress. I had been working for Anil for almost a month, and apart from cheating on the shopping, had not done anything in my line of work. I had every opportunity for doing so. Anil had given me a key to the door, and I could come and go as I pleased. He was the most trusting person I had ever met. At that night, when Anil kept the money under the mattress, Hari Singh was thinking that it has been almost a month for working for Anil. He is only cheating 1 rupees a daily on the shopping. Apart from that, he didn't steal anything from his house. He had every opportunity for doing so because Anil had given him the key of the door. He could come and go whenever he want. He had never met so trusting person in his life. Next line. And that is why it was so difficult to rob him. It is easy to rob a greedy man because he can afford to be robbed. But it is difficult to rob a careless man. Sometimes he doesn't even notice he has been robbed, and that takes all the pleasure out of the work. Hari Singh was thinking, thief was thinking that it is very difficult to rob him because he was a very careless person. According to the thief, it is easy to rob a greedy man because he can afford to be robbed. But it is very difficult to rob a careless man because he doesn't know where has he kept his things. So if we rob a careless person, he will never notice that his things has been stolen. So there is no pleasure robbing a careless person. Well, it's time I did some real work. I told myself I am out of practice, and if I don't take the money, he will only waste it on his friends. After all, he doesn't even pay me. Hari Singh, thief, was talking to himself, and he was saying that it is the right time to steal the money. He is out of practice, and if he will not take the money, Anil will waste all the money on his friends, and he is not even paying him the salary, so he decided to steal the money. Anil was asleep. A beam of moonlight stepped over the balcony and fell on the bed. I sat up on the floor. Considering the situation, if I took the money, I could catch the 10:30 express to Lucknow. Slipping out of the blanket, I crept up to the bed. Anil was sleeping peacefully. His face was clear and unlined. Even I had more marks on my face, though mine were mostly scars. Anil was sleeping, but Hari Singh was not sleeping. He was waiting for the right time. He was thinking that if he'll take the money, he could easily catch 10:30 express to Lucknow, and he can go to Lucknow. So he slipped out from his blanket, crept to the bed where Anil was sleeping. When he reached there, he saw that Anil was sleeping peacefully. His face was clear and unlined, and there were not a single mark on his face, but there were scars on Hari Singh's face. Next line. My hand slid under the mattress, searching for the note. When I found them, I drew them out without a sound. Anil sighed in his sleep and turned on his side towards me. I was startled and quickly crawled out of the room. Hari Singh slid his hand under the mattress and searched for the note. When he found them, he drew them out without making a sound. While he was doing so, Anil turned towards him in his sleep. So Hari Singh moved from there and crawled out of the room. When I was on the road, I began to run. I had the notes at my waist, held there by the string of my pajamas. I slowed down to a walk and counted the notes. 600 rupees in 50s. I could live like an oil-rich Arab for a week or two. When he came to the road, he began to run so that no one can catch him. He took the notes at his waist, held there by the string of his pajama. After moving afar, he slowed down so that he can count the money. He counted the money, and the total money was 600 rupees. He thought that he could live like an oil-rich Arab for a week or two with that money. When I reached the station, I did not stop at the ticket office. I had never bought a ticket in my life, but dashed straight to the platform. The Lucknow Express was just moving out. The train had still to pick up speed, and I should have been able to jump into one of the carriages, but I hesitated. For some reason I can't explain, and I lost the chance to get away. When Hari Singh reached the station, he did not stop at the ticket office because he had never bought a ticket in his life. He thought that it's a waste of money, so he never bought the ticket. So he ran to the platform directly without waiting at the ticket office. When he reached the platform, he saw that Lucknow Express was just moving out, still to pick up the speed. If he would have tried, he would easily jump into one of the carriages. But he hesitated, and he doesn't know the reason why he hesitated, but he lost his chance to get away, and the train left the platform. When the train had gone, I found myself standing alone on the deserted platform. I had no idea where to spend the night. When the train had gone, he saw that he was standing alone on that platform. No one was there. He doesn't know where to spend the night. I had no friends. Believing that friends were more trouble than help, he never made friends because he thought that friends never help. They always give you trouble. And I did not want to make anyone curious about staying at one of the next page. Small hotel near the station. He doesn't have any luggage, briefcase or suitcase, something or bag. So he didn't want to stay in any hotel because people will think what he's doing in the city with that much of money without any luggage. So he rejected that idea that he should stay in any hotel. Only person I knew really well was the man I had robbed. Leaving the station, I walked slowly through the bazaar. Only person he knew in that city was Anil. So when he left the station, he was walking towards the bazaar. In my short career as a thief, I had made a study of men's faces when they had lost their goods. The greedy man showed fear, the rich man showed anger, the poor man showed acceptance, but I knew that Anil's face when he discovered the theft would show only a touch of sadness, not for the loss of money, but for the loss of trust. He was a very successful thief, so he made a study of men's face whenever they had lost their goods. According to the thief, when a greedy man has been robbed, he shows fear. Whenever a rich man is robbed, he shows anger. Whenever the poor man robbed, he shows acceptance. But he knew that Anil would be very sad, not because of the loss of money, but because for the loss of trust. He trusted Hari Singh and Hari Singh broke his trust. So he would be very sad. I found myself in the Maidan and sat down on a bench. The night was chilly. It was early November, and a little drizzle added to my discomfort. Soon it was raining quite heavily. My shirt and pajamas got stuck to my skin, and a cold wind blew the rain across my face. While he was walking, he reached a maidan, a ground. So he sat on a bench to take some rest, but it was November and the wind was very chilly and suddenly started drizzling and it converted into heavy rain. Due to rain, his shirt and pajama got stuck to his skin and cold wind blew the rain across his face. I went back to the bazaar and sat down in the shelter of the clock tower. To keep himself away from the rain, he went back to the bazaar and took shelter under the clock tower. The clock showed midnight. I felt for the notes. They were damp from the rain. When he looked at the clock, it was 12 midnight. He touched the note. He felt that Notes were damp because of the rain. They got wet. Anil's money in the morning he would probably have given me 2 or 3 rupees to go to the cinema. But now I had it all. I couldn't cook his meal, run to bazaar, or learn to write whole sentence anymore. He was thinking that if Anil would be having this money in the morning, he would be giving him 2 or 3 rupees to go to cinema. Now he had all the money because he had stole all the money. But now he cannot cook his meal. He cannot go to bazaar. He cannot learn how to write any sentence. I had forgotten about them in the excitement of the theft. He was so excited about the theft that he forgot that he was learning how to cook and how to read. Whole sentence I knew could one day bring me more than a few hundred rupees. It was a simple matter to steal and sometimes just as simple to be caught. But to be a really big man, a clever and respected man, was something else. I should go back to Anil, I told myself, if only to learn to read and write. He was thinking that it is easy to steal and it is also easy to get caught. But if he want to become a really big, clever and respected man, he should go back to Anil, he told himself. I hurried back to the room feeling very nervous, for it is much easier to steal something than to return it undetected. He was feeling very nervous because stealing money or stealing anything is easy, but keeping that thing or returning that thing undetected without being caught is very difficult. I opened the door quietly and stood in the doorway. In clouded moonlight, Anil was still asleep. When he reached the room, he opened the door quietly and he saw that Anil was still asleep. I crept to the head of the bed and my hand came up with the note. He crept to the bed where Anil was sleeping, so he took the money in his hand. I felt his breath on my hand. I remained still for a minute, then my hand found the edge of the mattress and slipped under it with the notes. He waited for a minute so that Anil do not get up. He waited for the right time, and when the right time came, he slipped the money under the mattress. In the next morning when he got up, it was late. Anil already got up and made the tea for both of them. He stretched out his hand towards me. There was a 50 rupees note between his finger. Anil was having a 50 rupee note between his fingers and he was giving it to Hari Singh. My heart sank. I thought I had been discovered. Hari Singh thought he has been discovered. Anil know that I took the money. He was very afraid. I made some money yesterday, he explained. Now you will be paid regularly. But to his surprise, Anil said, I made some money yesterday. Now I'll pay you regularly. My spirit rose. But when I took the note, I saw it was still wet from the night rain. For a moment, I thought I have not been caught. I made him fool. But when I took the money, note was still wet, which means he knew that I took the money and I kept the money back. Today, we will start writing sentence, he said. He looked at me and said, we will start writing today. He knew, but neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. He knew that I took the money, I stole the money and again returned it, but he didn't show anything either from his lips or from his eyes. I smiled at Anil in my most appealing way and the smile came by itself without any effort. Hari Singh smiled at Anil to impress him, but this time he didn't make any effort. The smile came by itself, naturally. I hope you have understood the chapter. Please read the chapter carefully. This is a very good chapter and question will definitely come in the exam from this chapter. I hope you all have understood the chapter. I will see you in the next class. Till then, take care. Have a nice day.